Welcome and good morning once again, dear student, in my channel, and we are dealing with the animal diversity third, in which we have already studied the chordates as well as protochordates, characters of chordate and protochordate, and we have recently studied the general characters of Pisces. Now, in the Pisces, today we'll see the types of scales in this fishes, Pisces or fishes, and we are going to deal with these scales. Generally, in vertebrates, the scales are originating from these kinds of the dermis and epidermis. In vertebrates, the exoskeleton is made from epidermis as well as dermis, and this epidermal scales generally which are present in reptiles, aves and mammals. In case of Pisces, the scales generally arises or originates from dermis, and these kinds of the scales, which are small, thin, cornified, calcareous or bony plates, and originate from the dermis, comes out from this dermis through the epidermal origin. As you know, the skin which is having the two layer, in that is dermis, which is the innermost layer, and the outermost layer is called as epidermis. These kinds of the epidermis and dermis, these two layer forming the skin, and these scales in case of fishes originating from these both layers. Most of the fishes which are having these kinds of the dermal scales, but in case of some fishes which are having the epidermal as well as dermal scales. These kinds of the scales generally classified by this Lagler and Wichert in 1977 as well as 1970, and according to them they are classified the various type of the scales in fishes. Today we'll see this different kinds of the scales which are present in fishes. So let's see the types of scales in fishes which are going to form the protective covering over the skin. Generally, the scales which are to be classified in two main categories, one is placoid and another is non-placoid. The placoid scales are originating from this epidermis as well as dermis, and these are present in this elasmobranch fishes, while these non-placoid scales are originating from the dermis only. Then these non-placoid scales are further classified into these cosmoid, ganoid as well as bony plates. These cosmoid scales, which are generally present in extinct low fin fishes as well as latimarians. These kinds of the ganoid scales, which are again classified or divides into two subtypes. One is Palaeonyx squid and Lepidostenoid. Then this third bony plate, which is again further divide into two subtypes. One is cycloid and another is tenoid. And tenoid is present in highly developed fishes, that is teleost as well as dipnoi. So this is about this diagrammatic chart which explain the types of scales. Now afterwards we'll see the structure of these different types of scales. We will see the scales one by one. First of all, we will see the placoid scales, which are present in elasmobranch fish only. That is, these kinds of the placoid scales which are present in sharks, These placoid scales are arising from the this dermis as well as epidermis. And these placoid scales, which are backwardly directed and can't easily remove from the skins. So this is the structure of placoid scales, which are present in elasmobranch branch. These placoid scales are having one median spine, and it is also having the this basal plate. This basal plate is present. On these basal plates, this is generally like this rhomboidal basal plate, which is present and which is having the this trident spine, which are arising from this basal plate. And this is a structure of the placoid scales, which are backwardly directed to the direction is towards the posterior sides. And why? Because just to avoid the friction while swimming, it will be easy to the fish to get swim or fast swim into the water. So this is about this structure of the placoid scales arising from this, originating from this dermis and comes out through the this epidermis on the skin of the fishes. And due to this backwardly directed structure, it gives like this sandpaper like appearance, scrubby nature, or this sandpaper like appearance. And which generally, as I have told about, it consists the two parts. One is called as the rhomboidal basal plate, and this embedded into the dermis. And the second one is this spine. These kinds of the spine, which is trident spine. This is a median spine, and these are two lateral spine. So this trident spine, which outward and having the backward direction through the epidermis, arises the or comes out through the epidermis. These kinds of the rhomboidal basal plate, which anchors into the connective tissue structure. That connective tissue structure is called as the this Sharpless fiber. And this Sharpless fiber, through which these kinds of the basal plate attach with this connective tissue, the spines which comes out. And this spine, which consists the dentine, and this dentine encloses a pulp cavity. This cavity is present, which called as a pulp cavity, and that cavity provides the nourishment or the nutrient to the developing scale. And this pulp cavity, which contain many odontoblasts, and along with these kinds of the dentine, it is also having the harder structure, that is heterodentine. So this is about the structure of placoid scales, which are present in elasmobranch fishes, that is it is present in sharks. Now the second type of scales are cosmoid type of scales. This is Greek word. This cosmoid means ornament. These are ornament like type of the scales, which are generally present in this certain osteoderms, placoderms, and extinct sarcopterygians, that is low fin fishes and lung fishes. But these are extinct fishes. And these cosmoid type of the scales, which are not present in living fishes, these are only present in extinct fishes. And nowadays, or the fishes which are present right now on the earth, these kinds of the cosmoid scales are not present in them. These are only present in extinct type of fishes. What is the characteristics or the structure of these fish these scales? These consist three layers. One, or this first layer, which is called as isopodine layer, and this is inner or deepest layer. This inner or deepest layer, that is isopodine, which have the channels for blood vessels. Then the second layer, which is a vascular layer, which is the middle layer, consisting of the this spongy bone containing numerous vessels or spaces. So this is middle layer, that is vascular layer, and third layer, that is cosmine layer, which is outer layer and consisting of dentine containing a pulp cavities. So that is about the cosmoid type of scale, only present in extinct fishes, not into the present living fishes. Next type of the scales are of ganoid type, and this ganoid means the brightness. These are also called as the rhomboidal scales because these are rhomboidal in shape, and these rhomboidal structures are arranged on the exoskeleton or on the skin. They are closely fitted together, and generally they are attached to each others or on the skin in the form of tiles. So these rhomboidal kinds of the scales are, these are the thick diamond shaped plates and closely fitted like tiles. So this is about the these kinds of the ganoid scales. And if you see the structure, this is a rhomboidal shape. Yeah, it is anteriorly, it is having the peg like structures. Then it is having the lines. These are called as the concentric lines of growth. Then at the one borders of this rhomboidal structure, one side, it is having the fangs, and at the center of that rhomboidal scale, it is having the nucleus. So this is the structure, and this is how they are present on the skin. Opening of this lateral line canal is also present on the midlaterally to the midlateral sides, both lateral sides. And as you know about this lateral canal, this lateral canals, which is a sensory organ which detect the current of water or this flow of water, it is present midlaterally on both sides. So this is about the this rhomboidal ganoid scales. And these kinds of the rhomboidal scales in Pisces, they are again divided into two subtypes. One is called as this paleoniscoids ganoid scales, and another is called as lepidostenoid ganoid scales. So these are the two type of the scales which are present in Pisces. This first paleoniscoid ganoid scales are layered bone. Isopodine is present. So this isopodine bone is present in this paleoniscoids, and this spongy bone which is absent, and these kinds of the cosmoid layer is reduced. So this isopodine is present, then spongy bone as well as the which is absent, and cosmoid layer is reduced. These kinds of the paleoniscoid, it gives the lustrous metallic shining, and due to this it shines into the this sunlight or the light. And the examples are Polypterus and Accipiens. So these are the fishes in which these paleoniscoid ganoid scales are present. So this is a one type. And in second type, that is lepidostenoid ganoid scales, in which this spongy bone and cosmoid layer is absent, and this ganoid contains many tubules, and they are arranged like tiles. So this is about the second type, lepidostenoid ganoid scales, and it is present in Lepidosteus fish. So this is about the this ganoid type of the scales. Now the next type of the scales are grouped in bony ridge scale, and it has the two type of the scales which comes in this bony ridge scale. One is cycloid scale and another is tenoid scale. So this is, this one above is cycloid scale and this one is tenoid scale. So what is about this bony ridge scale? these two cycloid and tenoid comes under this bony ridge, and this there is only slight difference between these two type of the scale, that is cycloids, because it is comb like structure or this teeth which is present in its posterior margin, in which this tenoid type of the scales. This tenoids or this ten means the comb. So this comb like structures which is present, so this is about this comb like structure, and that's why it is called as the tenoid scales. So this only the slight difference is that while the these kinds of the concentric lines are present in both type of the scales, and these concentric lines which help to detect the age of the fish or the growth of the fish is to be calculated or detected with the help of these concentric lines of growth. So that is the benefit of that concentric lines. We can calculate the age of the fish. So first of all, we'll see the cycloid type of the scale in this bony ridge scale. This is the structure of this cycloid type of the scales, and it is having these concentric lines, cyclic concentric lines, and this is the arrangements of the cycloid scales on the skin. Centrally, it has the nucleus, and again it is having the concentric lines of the growth, and it is having the proximal of anterior basal ends, and again to the distal or posterior free ends. So this is the structure in cycloid type of the scales, and these cycloid scales are a thin, flexible, translucent plate. These plates are having the circular structures in outline, and this structure is thicker insides or the center. And the cycloid type of the scales are composed of thin upper layer of bone of and these kinds of the lower layer of fibrous connective tissue. So this is about with these kinds of the this bone and fibrous connective tissue by which these cycloid type of the scales are made, and they are found into the fishes, that is lung fishes, which is also called as the this dipnoid, this group of lung fishes, then amoeba, then lower teleostomes, and examples are this carps and cods, codfish as well as the carps. So this is about the this cycloid type of the scales, and the last type of the scale, that is tenoid type of the scales. This tenoid type of the scales, they are somewhat or more similar to that of the cycloid type of the scales. This structure as well as arrangements are similar in both type of the scales. Then these kinds of the tenoid scales, they are more firmly attached, and their exposed hind part is not overlap, but bear numerous small comb like structures or the teeth, and on the basis of these they are called as the tenoid scales, these comb like structures. And these kinds of the tenoid scales are present into the fish like the this flounders, and this flounders, it is the peculiar fish which is having the both these kinds of the tenoid as well as cycloid type of the scales. It is having this tenoid scales dorsally and cycloid scale ventrally. So this is about the peculiarity of this flounders. Both type of the scales are present in this flounder type of the fish. So likewise, these are the different types of the scales. We have seen this placoid scales as well as non-placoid scales. In this non-placoids, we have seen these kinds of the this cosmoid, ganoids, cycloids as well as tenoid type of the scales. So this is the this types of scales. After the this classification and the types of scales with their structures, now we'll see the uses of scales. What are the uses of scales to the fishes? As these scales which are present on the exoskeleton or on the skin of the fishes. What are the uses of that scales that we will see? First and foremost important, this function of the scale is which form the protective covering of exoskeleton on body. So with these kinds of the scales, the skin of the fish is covered, and with the help of this scale, and automatically the skin and the body of the fish is get protected into the water. So that is important function of the scales, to protect the skin of the fishes. As well as these kinds of the fishes which secrete the slimy mucus secretion. This slimy mucus secretion come out through the skin on the scale, and again it slimy mucus secretion which generally lubricate these kinds of the scales, which are generally calcareous in nature. And due to this, automatically while swimming into the water, it minimizes the friction with the help of this mucus on the scales. And it also kept this kind, with the help of this mucus, the bacteria or foreign pathogens are get kept away from the skin. Along with that, there are again different uses to the human beings or the mankinds of the scales, are that with the help of these scales we can classify the fish, as well as we can identify the fish. The identification and classification, broad identification classifications, is carried out with the help of scales. As you know, the placoid scales are present generally in cartilaginous fishes, and the cycloid, tenoid type of the scales are present in bony fishes or these osteichthyes fishes. So this classification and identification is done with the help of these scales, as well as with these kinds of the concentric lines of the growths, such lines of the growths which are present on the scales. With the help of this, we can determine the age of the fish. So to calculate the age or determine the age, these kinds of the concentric lines helps. So this is again the use of the scales of the this fishes. With the help of this, we can calculate or determine the age. So classification and identification of the fish, to determine the age of the fish, forming the protective coverings on the body. So these are the uses of the scales. So hope with this you understand all these different types of the scales, as well as uses of the scales in fishes. And thank you very much for watching the entire video.